Hey everyone, welcome to the ranking. Here's my ranking of Alexander Payne's movies. Yes, the movie Downsizing just came out a few weeks ago, and I thought to celebrate the movie Downsizing, I'd do a ranking of all that filmmaker's movies, which is Alexander Payne. So I'd rank all of Alexander Payne's movies from my least favorite to my favorite. Yes, Alexander Payne is a really great filmmaker. He's very unique. He's very different. He's very dark. At times, he's very out there with his ideas. And I thought I'd celebrate his movies. I've seen all seven of his films, so that's a plus. And yeah, I thought I'd rank all seven of his films, all the films he's directed, not just written, just directed. Yeah, I thought I'd just rank all of them from my least favorite to my favorite. So yeah, let's not waste any time. Here's my ranking of Alexander Payne's movies. All right, coming in at number seven is, unfortunately, the movie that came out just, well, technically last year, because it's now 2018, is Downsizing. Downsizing is ambitious, it's different, it's unique, I appreciate it, I admire it for its different in its originality. I like that it is doing something that's way out there, and like, I don't want the same ideas and stuff. There's so many movies that have so many remakes, reboots, and sequels, and just not at all original ideas. This is a very different and original film. Unfortunately, it's not executed properly, it goes on for too long, and just a lot of, there's like a subplot that is just ridiculous and just doesn't fit well with the story. And yeah, I've ranted about this movie when I did my quick movie reviews. Matt Damon is very good in this film. I thought he gave a great performance. The idea and the concept is really different and unique, and I admire it for its idea and its storyline and its plot. It's just such a cool idea for a film. Again, they just don't use it all to their advantage. The comedy doesn't always hit. The last 25 minutes is ridiculous, and I just did not like how this movie ended. The last 25 minutes is not that great. The rest of the film is still enjoyable enough, and I still gave it a positive review because I still think it's a decent film. Just, it goes on for too long, and it has a ridiculous last 25 minutes. It's a stupid subplot, and just, I wish they explored more with the idea of like shrinking yourself and becoming like a small person in this society to help you with your financial, help make the world a better place and stuff. I just wish they went more into that, the politics of that and the science of that, but they really didn't. It's mostly about Matt Damon's life, which is fine because Matt Damon is still really great and a very likable character. And it starts off promising, there's good stuff in it, just the last 25 minutes almost damn near ruined the film for me. The movie itself is just decent. It could have been amazing. It's just okay. Coming number six is Citizen Ruth. Citizen Ruth stars Laura Dern, and this is a movie that's a little hard to talk about. I just watched this movie about a month ago because I was planning on to do this ranking in the new year, and I don't have much to say about this movie. It's a decent drama. It's a decent comedic film. Laura Dern gives a great performance. The story is fine, there is some originality to it, there are some really funny references in this film, but all in all, it's just kind of passable. It's a one and done for me. I watched it, it's fine, it's critically acclaimed, which is cool, but it's a one and done for me. Nothing groundbreaking about this movie, nothing that has the watchability factor for me. It's still a better film than Downsizing, but it's just fine for me. Coming number five is About Schmidt. About Schmidt, now we're into the good Alexander Payne films. About Schmidt is also kind of a one and done for me, but still a really great film. I think Jack Nicholson knocks out of the park. He is so good. Even Kathy Bates is good. I love the story about this man who always was like pampered by his wife and stuff, and basically always listened to everything she had to say, but then when she passes away, he doesn't know what to do with his life. So basically, he kind of goes on a road trip and everything, and runs into different kind of characters and everything, and he's a very fascinating character, and I thought Jack Nicholson gave a great performance. I thought he was so good in this film. The film does go on for too long, and some of the comedy doesn't work. Sometimes this movie is very funny. Sometimes it is not, and it just comes off very awkward and a bit clunky at times. And if this movie was trimmed down by like 20 minutes, I think this would have been a more solid, more cohesive story. All in all, I think this is still a great film. I never watched it ever a second time. I watched this once, about 4 or 5 years ago. I still really, really liked it. It's just nothing I ever put on ever again. Maybe I will in the future, but until then, maybe not. It's still a great film, though. Coming number four is Nebraska. Nebraska, yes. again, like, about Schmidt, I've only seen this movie once. Don't plan on buying the Blu-ray. Don't plan on actually watching it again, even though I think this is a terrific, terrific film. It's a wonderfully acted film with great comedy, great drama. I love the story of this old man who thinks he, like, won the all this money off this contest and everything. He goes back to his old town in Nebraska where the people didn't like him and everything. He goes on this road trip with his son, played by Will Forte. Is it Will Forte? Forte, yeah. The guy from Last Man on Earth. Very funny show, by the way. He's great. Will Forte is fantastic in this film. Bruce Dern is good. I don't understand why he was nominated for an Oscar. I thought he gave a good performance. Nothing amazing, though. June Squibb, though, I thought she stole the film. She was so funny, so enjoyable. I thought she gave an excellent performance. I thought June Squibb was the best performance in this film. She was fantastic. Loved her in this movie. Even Will Forte was better. Bruce Dern is still good. I don't know why he got the Oscar nomination. It's not that great of a performance. It's good. The story, I love that it's a black and white movie. It just sets the tone of what kind of film you're into. It has this very neo-noir kind of setting and kind of style, and just tonally it feels very neo-noir. That's why it's all black and white and stuff. And it's really good, this movie. I thought this was actually a very sensational film. It's actually a much better film than About Schmidt, even though About Schmidt's still a great film. The writing, the direction, the execution, the cinematography, all great in this movie. Just doesn't have the watchability factor. I watched it once when this movie came out at the very ending of 2013. Haven't watched it again. It's a great movie for old people. It's like an old person kind of movie. Don't want to stereotype or anything, but it's a very old person kind of movie. I said the same thing about the movie Youth when I watched that a few years ago. That's what Nebraska is. It's kind of like an old person movie. Maybe I'd love it more when I get older, but it's still a great film. Does it have the watchability factor? Still great, though. Coming number three is Election. Election, yes, this has a watchability factor. I've been watching this movie for years. This is one of the darkest, probably one of the most darkest comedic films Alexander Payne has made. This is a dark film. Very dark. Loved every minute of it. It was so good. Reese Witherspoon and Matthew Broderick are both great in this film. Basically, it's about this girl named Trixie, and she wants to be the class president and stuff, and Matthew Broderick cannot stand her. He hates her guts. And basically, he wants to see her whole election just get wiped, and he doesn't want her to win and stuff. He just can't stand her as a human being and stuff, and basically, he does very unlikable things to basically try to get his way and stuff. She even does a lot of unlikable things so she can become class president and everything. This movie is filled with very despicable, very unlikable characters. And once you know that going in, that you're not supposed to like these people, then you can enjoy the film a lot more, because a lot of people, the biggest problem people have with this film is that it's too distasteful and it's very unlikable. That's the whole point of the film, though. You're watching a story filled with very despicable people. And it's wonderfully acted, and it is very funny. There's a lot of scenes that I just laugh so hard. It is just so funny. I think there's maybe one or two likable characters, but the movie's filled with just the most selfish and despicable people, and that's the whole point of the film. And a lot of them actually get bad endings anyway, so kind of a plus in my books. But this movie is really good, and it's a very watchable film. I love watching this movie. It's dark as shit, but it's good. Coming number two is a film that I desperately wanted to put at number one. But my number one, it's still a better film, but this movie came so close, and that's The Descendants. The Descendants is such a good movie. I love this movie. I absolutely adore it. I think this is so good. This was one of my favorite films of 2011. I think this is amazing. George Clooney is fantastic. George is just so freaking awesome in this movie. Shailene Woodley is amazing as well. Oscar-worthy performance by Shailene Woodley. She is amazing. Even Judy Greer's in this film. She's really great. Matthew Lillard, he's good in this movie. Basically, the story of this movie is about George Clooney. His wife is on life support. She's almost dying and stuff. And it's a very weird story because his wife is dying, but he found out that his wife has been cheating on him the whole time, and she was planning on leaving him for another man and stuff, and it's just like, whoa, like, that's very interesting, because you're like, how do I react to that? My wife is dying, I love my wife, but she's cheating on me, and she wants to leave me and stuff. And then basically, he goes on this, like, kind of journey with his two daughters, one of them's Shailene Woodley, basically to find the man that has been sleeping with his wife and stuff. So basically, he can say goodbye to her while she's on life support and stuff. And the more you learn more about the guy and more about this family, the more interesting this movie is and stuff. The movie takes all place in Hawaii and stuff. So it's beautiful. The location's fantastic. The setting's fantastic. A lot of great cinematography, great editing. And the performances are so good. This movie is beautifully written too. The screenplay is amazing. This one best adapted screenplay at the Oscars, very well deserved. This movie is just so good. It's got great comedy, great drama, amazing characters. George Clooney is fantastic. Shailene Woodley's fantastic. Everyone's fantastic. I absolutely adore this film. This is one of my favorite Alexander Payne films. I love every second of this film. I wanted to put this at number one, but my number one is still my favorite. Let's get to number one. And my number one favorite Alexander Payne movie is It's Sideways. Sideways is the best Alexander Payne film I've ever watched. Dramatically, comedically, stylistically, just storytelling-wise, it's the best. The writing, the direction, the performances, everything is just so raw and real and dark and realistic. Just everything about this movie is just amazing. Paul Giamatti, Thomas Hayden Church are both fantastic in this film. They are both very unlikable, but also likable characters. Basically, if you took all the likability of both of them, they would be the most likable person ever. But you took the unlikability of both of them, put that together, it'd be the most despicable piece of shit ever. They both do very despicable things in this film, but they also have a lot of charm, but they also have a lot of likability in them. They're great characters. I thought both Paul Giamatti and Thomas Hayden Church both gave great performances. They're interesting characters. They both have fantastic chemistry with each other. Feel like you're on this journey with them. You feel like you're on this, like, you know, this bachelor party with them when they're going through wine country and everything, tasting all this amazing wine and pure noir and stuff. And it's just such a great film. I love this movie. The dramatic scenes are so compelling. The comedic scenes are so freaking funny. It's just such a real and such a personal story. The ending is so deep and so thought-provoking. Everything about Sideways is absolutely fantastic. This is Alexander Payne's best film, in my opinion. I absolutely adore it, and it's hands down my favorite, and I do think it's his best. So yeah, that was my ranking of all of Alexander Payne's movies, from at least favorite to my favorite. So yeah, in the comment section below, please tell me, did you agree with this ranking? If not, give me your ranking of all of Alexander Payne's movies, in your opinion, from at least favorite to your favorite. Comment below, let me know. And as always, with this video, please like, subscribe to this channel, and join the dark side.